Our today's hero is Krzysztof Kieślowski, one of the most important and the most well-known Polish directors. At first, he made documentary movies, but after that, he took to fiction films. His career path was not an easy one. He was not accepted to the theater academy at all, and he got into film school in Łódź at the third attempt, and there he was neither the best student nor had the best grades. Kieślowski was one of the students of Kazimierz Karabasz. Do you know who he is? If you don't know, you can listen to the episode about the musicians. Karabasz supervised the making of one of Kieślowski's popular movies, his short movie From the City of Łódź. Krzysztof Kieślowski directed many documentary movies. For example, Pedestrian Subway, Refrain, Talking Heads, Seven Women of Different Ages, First Love, and From a Night Porter's Point of View. The last one is one of my favorite documentary movies. This is what Kieślowski said about his career. When we take up something, we all want to change the world. I think I had never hoped for it, as I thought I would only manage to describe the world. His first significant feature was Persona. This movie is considered a piece from the period of cinema of moral unrest. This current lasted from 1976 till 1981. It is thought to be the most important period of the Polish cinema since Polish film school, which developed after World War II. Main features of the cinema of moral unrest are current topics, the use of realistic method of word exposition, the action is set in province with a strictly defined environment, and the young character experiencing the initiation process. The plot is usually based around the characters grow into rebellion. If we take a realistic look at the moral unrest movies, we can see that the ending is rarely happy for the main character. He or she has to face up to the surroundings reality and accept the moral defeat. In 1979, one of Kieślowski's most important movies, Camera Buff, was firstly released. It is a story of a man whose life changes because of an amateur camera he bought, which turns him into a soulless spectator. The movie won International Evangelical Jury Award at the Berlin Film Festival. If I wanted to tell you about all Kieślowski's movies, or at least about his most important ones, I wouldn't have enough time today. But I just have to mention the TV series The Ten Commandments or The Decalogue. It is a series of 10 movies inspired by Jewish and Christian Ten Commandments. According to the Bible, these moral rules were spoken to Moses by God. There are many versions of the Ten Commandments in English, but I will present you maybe the most useful translation I found. The first commandment: I am the Lord, the God, thou shalt not have any strange gods before me. Second, thou shalt not take the name of the Lord, the God, in vain. Three, remember to keep holy the Sabbath day. Fourth, honor the father and the mother. Fifth, thou shalt not kill. Sixth, thou shalt not commit adultery. Seventh, thou shalt not steal. Eighth, thou shalt not bear false witness against thy neighbor. Nine, thou shalt not covet the neighbor's wife. Ten, thou shalt not covet the neighbor's goods. Kieślowski in his movies puts an artistic interpretation of those rules. It is very interesting series. The most important movies of which are a short movie about killing based on the fifth commandment and a short movie about love based on the sixth commandment. My personal favorite is the first episode, which shows extensive trust we have in modern technologies. I have to tell you that it is sad that the message of a short film about killing contributed to the abolition of death penalty in Poland. By criminal law, the death penalty in Poland was abolished in 1998 and ultimately even during the war in 2013. But this penalty has not been carried out since 1988. The last death sentence was carried out on 21st of April 1988 in Kraków, a year after the premiere of the movie. Finally, I'd like to tell you a few words about Kieślowski's movies, which were made after he emigrated to France and which are regarded some of the most important movies in the history of the European cinema. These movies are The Double Life of Veronique and The Three Colors trilogy. The colors blue, white and red reflect three values: liberté, égalité, fraternité, freedom, equality and fraternity, which are connected to the French flag. The saying was popularized during the French Revolution, and today it is one of the symbols of the country. An interesting fact is that in 1994, the movie Three Colors Red was nominated for the main award in Cannes, along with Pulp Fiction of Quentin Tarantino. Clint Eastwood was the head of jury back then. Pulp Fiction won, but even Tarantino said that the movie Three Colors Red was the best movie of the festival. There are many more things I should tell you about Kieślowski, but it would be a very long story. I recommend watching Kieślowski's movies, also the documentary ones, which show the reality of the 60s and 70s in Poland. I believe you will find these movies interesting. Enjoy and talk to you soon.